So, for the, so how are you guys feel today?
Okay.
Slightly sleepy.
It's actually been a while since the Toastmaster had a Toastmaster meeting because we had a sem break. So here we are again, going like carrying on the Toastmasters meeting. And today we have a team for you guys. Ivan.
Show us on your net during
something. I didn't learn any dancing, unfortunately. At first, we didn't go to clubbing. Okay. So, do you guys like the song?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, thanks. Okay, so basically, the song that you guys just heard just now is Take On Me. Take On Me by AHA! Isn't it a very catchy artist name? And also, most importantly, the song itself. So before this, right, AHA wasn't that famous as they are now. Before this, they were just like a typical artist doing their songs, publishing their songs, and not many audience listened to it. But so happened that it was a miracle for this song. After filming the MV for 2 months and they launched it and they finally published it, and it got a very good response. It put AHA in a very fast track into the road of fame. So what's the take home message behind this incident? So like in our life, right, in our daily life, we are always doing things that we thought they are mundane. Like, okay, for example, we have a goal to achieve and we are clear that we are going to achieve this goal. So we'll make our progression and try to reach to our destination. But throughout the journey, like throughout in the progression towards this goal, we have setbacks, we have obstacles, we have challenges that might turn us down. Like we thought that, oh, we are not making an impact. No, my progress is too slow and I'm not reaching anything. But just believe that one day it will happen that like things will come unexpected to us, and just don't lose this faith, have hope, and don't give up. Just keep doing the things that you're doing, having faith that you'll achieve it one day. And this day is a question mark. It will happen on the day that you will not expect. Yeah, that's basically the idea from this incident. Now, today we have a few guests that is coming from outside. First of all, sorry, the sentence structure is a bit off. Okay, now first off, from on my left, we have Ethan Gaines, or Ganes. He's from Sunway University, Toastmasters Club, same as the guy beside him. His name is Chink. Not the guy, the senpai. I don't know what they call him. Okay, his name is Chink. And then, next up, we have someone who got promotion. His name? So we have Ricky Su. He is from PJ Toastmasters Club. And moving to the left, next to Ricky, we have a girl. She's from Sunway Toastmasters.
Girl.
Girl, yeah. She's from Sunway Toastmasters. Her name is Andrea, right? Yeah.
Adria.
Okay. Her name is Adria. Yeah, her name is Adria. And then to the G of the day. His name is
Why?
Huh?
Come on.
Can't pronounce, you can't pronounce that.
You introduce yourself.
You can't do it.
they can be
one of the characters in Street Fighter.
Huh?
One of the characters in Street Fighter.
Barbie's boyfriend. Oh, I give so many hits.
Ken. So we have Ken from EXO Toastmasters. And then from the right side, we have Abba Wai Chuan. And then we have we have we have Lena. Lena, would you mind to introduce yourself, like where you're from?
OUM Toastmasters.
Okay. We have Lena from OUM Toastmasters. She will be our counter for our meeting today. And then we have Bowie. And then next to Bowie, we have Stanley from Friendship Toastmasters. And then
Stanley, stand up lah.
Okay, and then for the timekeeper of the day, we have Len Kalai. We have Kalai. She's from somewhere you see Toastmasters stuff. And not last but not least, we have Ben. He's from
Friendship.
Yeah, Ben's from Friendship Toastmasters Club.
How about the boxer?
Huh?
The boxer.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, he's from Mother's Indy, right?
He's from our club also, and Sunway Music Toastmasters. He has both membership, like dual membership. And we have the IPP of ICS Toastmasters Club. CCCL Winnie Wong.
Hi guys.
Right. Good evening to everyone of us, and I hope you guys will enjoy the meeting later on. Now I shall pass the floor to the Toastmasters of the evening, Abba Wai Chuan.
Thank you to our president, Hong Wei. You know, when this team first came on, it took me quite a while to figure out what it means. The take on me, the first impression was that it is an extreme version or an exaggerated version of pick on me. You know, bully, when you bully people, you're like, I pick on that person. Take on me is like you challenge the bully to pick on you, like, I dare you, pick on me. Hey, pick on me. Sorry, take on me. Then I was like, wait, no. It sounds too negative. So I figured if I could add something in the middle. Take whatever you want, it's on me. Or take this thing off my body, it is on me. Mm. But then, if it's supposed to be constructed that way, it should have been that way. But no, it's a very elegantly constructed phrase, take on me. Then I understood the meaning. It's about courage. It's about the tenacity to face daily challenges. To make decisions for yourself when you are faced with obstacles. And also to constantly encourage and have the motivation to go on. And of course, since every one of us here are familiar with Toastmasters, I'm going to skip all the history and the phases of the meeting as we go straight